I'm with you.
Salt.
Let's see some sparks fly! What the hell you got?
Yeah! Oh, we look three!
Now that's a
So, give up yet? I'm just getting started. I could take you one arm only. Ha! Small fry. I want to find somewhere to put my feet up.
Honorary member of the Moles, listen up. Thank you for helping Hook find the detector. But now, Hook needs to ask you another favor. Hook and Daddy's birthday is approaching. Every year at this time, we exchange gifts and celebrate our birthday together. Yeah? What's the problem? Daddy's job has been more difficult since moving to Boulder Town. He gets home really late every day. I don't want to use his hard-earned money to buy a gift. Hey, are you patronizing me? Actually, I still have some valuable treasure of my own in Rivet Town. It's a shame I left it there. If I go bring it back and sell it for a decent price, I can buy a gift for Daddy without begging anyone for money. I know that Rivet Town is super dangerous right now. That's why I'd like to enlist you as my bodyguard. That way, even if the old witch finds out later, I won't be the only one getting a scolding. Then it's settled! Let's meet in Rivet Town. I'll be waiting for you in a safe spot. You're not allowed to not come. What took you so long? Hook's been waiting here for ages. Well, it wasn't actually that long. As long as you're here now, it's fine. I got some good news and some bad news. Which do you want to hear first? Julian is willing to contribute to our adventure! Look, he gave me this gardening shovel. News is that he asked us to help him get some treasure. Otherwise, he'll tell the old witch about our plan. Well, Julian has been a huge help to me. Consider this returning the favor. Well, the treasure won't grow legs and find us, will it? Come on, let's go.
Give these trailblazers your blessing!
Who will it be?
that all.
Who will it be? Oh, stars, give these trailblazers your blessing!
Now that's a gold-winning victory. I'm with you.
Julian's adoptive parents used to own a business in this area. When we were all forced to leave the town, there were lots of things they didn't have time to take with them, so... Shouldn't be too hard to locate his treasure. Let's start by looking over there! We found Julian's treasure! No, not the key! These glass marbles! Oh, look at all the different colors. Bet it wasn't easy collecting all these. No, these marbles are what he's after. I'm also curious. What does this key open? Oh, let's ask Julian when we get back! What's that look on your face? Oh, I get it. You don't think this jar of glass marbles is worth anything, right? Don't even try to pretend otherwise. Look on your face sold you out. Let me tell you something. This jar of marbles means a lot to the moles. Julian used it to help the moles overcome a super huge crisis for which he was promoted to second in command. It was a super huge crisis that jeopardized the mole's honor. In the past, the kids in town were arch rivals to us at the orphanage. Those kids used to bully us, relying on the pocket money that their parents gave them. One time, they sent us a formal declaration of war, challenging the moles to a marbles competition. We were all well aware that we didn't stand a chance. We at the orphanage only had some old glass marbles we scavenged from the side of the road, which are no match for those rich kids' marbles. Nonetheless, Julian bravely accepted the challenge and triumphantly returned with a pile of colorful glass marbles he won. It was incredible. Yep. So, now you know why he wanted us to find this treasure. All right, enough chit-chat. Next, we need to find my treasure. Time to get to work. Hook's treasure is hidden below the orphanage near the mine's entrance. This doesn't feel like the Rivet Town I remember. Do you think the orphanage is like this now, too? This place is nothing like it was before I left. Boxes and mine carts are all over the street. What a mess. Oh, did someone move my treasure too? I used to keep it in the mining team's junk pile. Behind the corner, there were heaps of geomarrow and boxes. Hopefully it hasn't been taken. I'll look with you. We'll definitely find it if we work together. This miniature drill rig was given to me by a guy from Daddy's mining team as a birthday present. I'm going to turn it on. Whoosh! Huh? It won't turn on. Look, just don't talk to me right now. I need to calm down. Honorary member? I wonder, how much do you think Julian's glass marbles would sell for? That's it? Ugh, guess I'll have to abandon my evil plan. will be pretty expensive to fix, right? Not possible. Daddy said that guy went missing one day and he never saw him again. Maybe he went someplace far away. I have no idea when he'll come back, so that definitely won't work. Oh, wait a second! I hid another treasure at the orphanage! I don't want to sell it, but if I want to buy Daddy a gift, I don't have any other choice. Honorary member, please, please help me look for it. Just one more time. Ah, yay! Let's go!
I'm with you.
Why are there so many monsters here? We need to deal with them first.
At all. The will forged in ice never falters!
Location where I stashed the treasure. It's a reward from the old witch. You'll know what it is after I dig it up. Go down the stairs on the left, then walk 10 paces forward. Turn right, walk another 15 paces, spin around 10 times, then keep walking forward. Oh no! I'm doomed! The second half of my notes are completely ruined! Oh, what kind of lame treasure map would it be if it only had one or two steps? Without the second half of my notes, how will I ever find the treasure? Really? Quick, let me see.
Let's use the home use object finder to help Hook search.
Future. Whatever. Since we've already dug it up, let's open it. I guess you're right. We should wait 50 years before opening it. Let's take it back to Julian along with the glass marbles.
Beep, beep. Create a calendar reminder for when you want to visit an Interastral Peace Appliances store.
Oh, here it is! My teddy bear! The old witch gave it to me as a gift. Yes! He's called Junjun. Whoa, Junjun. How did you get covered in dirt? And why do you have so many loose threads? If we don't get you cleaned up, no one will buy you. The old witch said that Junjun isn't just any old teddy bear. He'll be worth a lot of money once he's cleaned up. There's no other way. I haven't learned to sew yet. I'll have to ask the old witch for help. If she finds out I went somewhere I shouldn't have gone, Hook will get lectured all over again. What? So what if the old witch yells at me? Hook still has to prepare the gift for Daddy. We found the treasure. Let's split. The monsters here give Hook goosebumps. Ooh, too scary. I'm warning you. Don't you dare tell the old witch about Hook's plan to sell the treasure.
Find somewhere to put my feet up.
Hook? What are you...
Natasha? Junjun's in bad shape. Can you help me fix him?
I remember giving you Junjun. I haven't seen this fella in years. Where did you find him?
The wind brought him back to me.
Be honest with me, Hook.
Big Brother helped me find him in the Rivet Town orphanage.
You had him take you to the Fragmentum just for this teddy bear? Hook, how many times have I told you?
Natasha, please. Please help me fix Junjun. I'll clean the clinic for you for a whole month.
You say that every time, and then...
Great! See you soon! Big Brother, I'll leave Junjun with you.
What am I going to do with that girl? You shouldn't indulge her, outsider. I know it's difficult to tell Hook no, but sometimes it just has to be done. Junjun. So she gave her bear a name, huh? I've lost count of all the dolls I've made. To be honest, I wasn't expecting her to like this one so much. It was an award I used to give the kids in Rivet Town for good behavior. Can you imagine what an orphanage is like with so many difficult children? I mean, I had to come up with a solution to get them to behave. Hook pretended to be well-behaved for a month in order to get Junjun. She ate on time, slept on time, even stopped fighting with the other kids. I'm afraid you have no idea how much she suffered that month. Hook has an uncanny ability to rally people to her cause, both adults and children. It's a skill, all right. And forcing her to be well-behaved puts a lid on it. Well, this teddy bear has sure been through the wars. Don't worry, I'll help Hook repair Junjun. But I'll need to find some stuffing. Wait, look at the eyes. They must be... Erebus? Huh. Strange, I didn't notice when I sewed them on. There's no shortage of surprises in life. Well, our war-torn bear here just became a priceless doll. Not bad, Junjun.
Did the old witch yell at you? What? Why'd she only yell at Hook? Never mind that. You didn't tell her what I was really up to, did you? Great. Your loyalty as an honorary member of the Moles is acknowledged. Anyway, why are you still standing here, silly? Do you have something to report to the boss of the moles? Gems? Does that mean he's worth a lot of money? Well, what are you talking about? Of course I do. If the gems are expensive, Hook can buy a better birthday gift for Daddy. I don't want to keep Junjun's eyes. If some kid gets a Junjun with no eyes, they'll be sad, right? Anyhow, this is super useful intel. If you've been with the moles a bit longer, I'd be promoting you to third in command right now. I'll need your help again after Natasha fixes Junjun. Always be prepared to answer the call of Pitch Dark Hook the Great.
Where can I get some Snow White popping candy?
Things been cursed.
Ah, young lad. Something you want. Fortunately, Spartan, you still have a loan.
Well, my friends, are you ready to head out? Wonderful. Remember to bring enough food and drink to refuel on the way. We have a lot of steps to climb.
Returned.
Rania, I thought I'd lost you. Where were you? Are you hurt?
No, there's no need. I'm fine, really. I just got into a few skirmishes down in the underworld, but...
The underworld? In that case, report everything you saw. Commander, Rania.
After the failed pursuit at Backwater Pass, because of the difficult situation we were in, we also defeated an ancient robot known as Svarog.
I'm listening. Go on.
Madam Kokolia, it is my firm belief I witnessed them take up arms in the name of justice and risk their lives for the mother. And so, I ask you to forgive my defiance, but I believe that the-
Enough!
What?
Arrogant. Ignorant. Glimpse the tip of the iceberg. And guards! Take Branya.
They are not scum. My entire life. Everything you ever kept from me. Tell me what you have seen. What exactly it is you are hiding.
I knew this moment would come sooner or later. You want to know why I gave those orders?
Yes. I am ready. Mother?
Then come with me. Branya, it is time you heard it. The voice of this dying world.
Unreliable Sampo. He probably guessed we'd ask where his hiding place was. No sooner are we back in the administrative district than he sneaks off.
the Sis. If you're talking about Jeppard, we should be careful. He's a top Silvermane guard. He'd probably get a medal for every one of us he brought in. Don Hung, what do you think?
I think it'd be best to pay a visit to Serval Landau.
So you think we should avoid Jeppard for the time being, right?
He's an elite officer of the Silvermane Guards. It wouldn't be easy to get to him. Besides, if he hasn't been persuaded by Branya's letter, we'd be walking right into the lion's den.
Makes sense. Guess we better head over to Serval's workshop then?
But we must keep a low profile. We're still wanted fugitives.
What's wrong, Zila?
Nothing. It's just a little new. The last time I was on the surface, I was still a child. I have no memory of any of this. The overworld and the underworld. We've been cut off for so long. I'm okay. Let's go. There are so many Silvermane guards on patrol. Is it usually like this?
No. I don't remember the security being this tight last time. It might have something to do with us. The Supreme Guardian has probably learned of our arrival already. Branya.
You'll be safe here. My workshop has pretty good soundproofing and barely anyone comes in. Just what crime did you commit, exactly? They recalled a bunch of guards from the front line to track you down. It's unprecedented. Now they're patrolling the whole city and everyone's in a panic.
Oh, we just...
Not yet, March. Branya said we could trust you completely.
You mean to say you don't trust me completely? Good. That's smart of you. But you needn't worry. Kokolia and I aren't even on speaking terms. It was her that ejected me from the Architects. I refuse to stand with her. I don't believe you guys would do anything bad. And the Architects are gonna need conclusive and publicly available evidence for me to think otherwise. Besides, I know the Architects, and if they did have any evidence, they would have released it by now. I know Kokolia's style. Get everyone into a frenzy first. Most people in a frenzy don't stop to ponder the details. What Kokolia and the Architects get up to has nothing to do with me. My time is too precious for pondering. These days, I just spend my time fixing things in this workshop and playing music. It's a pretty carefree existence. If I'm not careful, I'll start boring you all with sob stories from the past. Let's get back to you guys. If long-lost Branya told you to come here, you must have something important to tell me. You can trust me. I know our paths have only crossed once before, but my intuition tells me you guys are good people. And I've got good intuition, by the way.
Ooh, I'm the best storyteller! Let me!
Try not to embellish the facts.
So that's what's been happening. No wonder we hadn't heard from Bronya recently. After all these years in isolation, and without a single word from below, this is what's become of the Underworld. I believe you. There's no way you could have invented all those twists and turns. What's more, we have Miss Sela here as living proof. As for the Stellaron, why Bronya got you to find me. When I was still one of the architects working in the scientific research division, I was researching the Stellaron. I never thought I'd hear that word again after being expelled by the architects. Come on, I'll tell you everything. Very few people in Bellabog know of the existence of the Stellaron. Those that do would never associate it with the Fragmentum or Eternal Freeze. But according to the data recorded in that robot, Svarog, the architects dug out the truth long ago. The research results were purposely hidden away to ensure that the outside world would never know of them. Just my luck. Out of all the research topics I could have chosen, I insisted on the Stellaron. It's clear now that anyone who wanted to get closer to the truth would have been expelled or abandoned. Maybe I should be thanking Kokolia. All she did was push me out. She could have decided to take a more permanent measure.
Thank you.
Kokolia, it's been so many years since we last spoke. We were great friends once. There was nothing we wouldn't share. She became a completely different person when she took on the Supreme Guardianship. She gave the order to expel me herself and refused to see me. Sometimes I even wonder, is she being compelled by previous generations? I figured out that the Stellaron and the Fragmentum were linked, so I was already close to the truth. It's a shame that the Architects ejected me before I could discover that the source of the Fragmentum was the Stellaron itself. Before I lost my position, I was applying for permission to survey the Stellaron directly. It was my research topic, but I'd never even set eyes on it. My research was all based on historical data and lab simulations. Not long after I submitted my preliminary report and application, I received my punishment. It was obvious that somebody didn't want my research to continue. Jappard? Not a chance. He's a decent guy, but also famously uncompromising. For my brother, orders are more important than anything. Even if you stuck Branya's letter to his forehead, he wouldn't be swayed. You need to choose your words carefully if you want to persuade him of something. It might be best if I talk to him. Though, I'd need a strategy first. Yes. I never observed it directly, but I used lab simulations and outbound surveys to establish a rough location. According to the survey results, the Stellaron is likely to the north of Bellabog, somewhere in the vast snow plains.
We must locate it as soon as possible, ideally before Kokolia takes action. Can you tell us the way?
Not a problem. I was thinking the same thing. But I'm afraid telling you might not be enough. The area to the north of Bellabog has been more or less swallowed up by the Fragmentum. If you want to get to the northern snow plains, you'll need to get past the Silvermane Guard restricted zone on the front lines first. Even if you get past the restricted zone in one piece, you'll have a whole heap of Fragmentum to deal with. Yes, that's where the main force of the Silvermane Guards is stationed. They've consolidated their position there in order to resist the encroaching Fragmentum.
Sounds like the three of us and Zila might not be enough. Why don't we go back underground and get Wildfire to come with us?
I fear we may not have the time.
Hey, enough pessimism. Back in my official capacity days, I spent a lot of time in the north. I got to know the soldiers and officers on the front line very well. This calls for brain waves, not brawn waves. How about I take you over myself?
Really? Great! Phew. It's less scary if someone you know is leading the way.
I want to see the Stellaron too, you know. It was my research topic for over a decade. You don't get that many decades in life. That's settled then. There's no time to lose. We should head out as soon as you're ready. Darn it! I forgot my brother said he'd be around today. Find somewhere to hide, quick! I'll handle him. Jappard! It's you! I didn't think you'd have the time to visit with things so tense on the front line.
Things are manageable. The latest wave of monster attacks has slowed. I'm back in the city to take care of a few matters, but I'll be back on the front line later. I thought I told you.
Oh, yes, that's right.
Sis, you look a bit pale. Did something happen?
No, why would anything have happened?
You don't normally use my full name.
You said you hate it when I call you bro in public. Well, I agree. It'd sound better if I started using your full name. Right, Brosin?
You can call me whatever you like. Look, Serval, I'm here on official business today. There's something wrong with the barrier generator device, and the engineers in our unit don't know how to fix it. I need you to take a look.
Those guys can't think outside the box. Of course they can't wrap their heads around my design. I thought it was something big. Leave it here. I'll take a look.
Sorry to trouble you.
Why are you being so polite? Oh, and why is the city under curfew all of a sudden? Has something happened?
I've been instructed to keep it quiet.
Lil Jeppy. So grown up now, looking down on his civilian sister.
Don't say that. Forget it. If I don't tell you, Payla will. Last night, Lady Bronya suddenly appeared. She entered Klopoth Fort without saying anything to anyone. The Supreme Guardian is worried that the three intruders may have followed Bronya out of the Fragmentum and back into the administrative district. She issued a curfew for the entire city and ordered us to pursue and capture any suspicious individuals.
Ah, so that's how it is. No wonder I haven't heard from Bronya. Is she all right?
I'm not sure. She hasn't left Klopoth Fort. The Supreme Guardian just said she'd returned. Nothing more.
Well, I was sure worried about her. After she disappeared, Payla's workload doubled. She said she barely had time to go out.
She really does tell you everything. Oh, by the way, I left my Goethe Hotel limited edition flask behind last time I was here. Let me have a look for it. I think I left it over...
Wait!
What is it? You seem pretty off today, Serval.
It's, right. You remember how you neglected all those flowers to death? I piled them all over there during a bit of spring cleaning, and now they smell terrible. So, don't go over there.
Seems like a strange reason not to take a look. Plus, am I supposed to believe you were spring cleaning? You must be up to more forbidden research.
I am not! How dare you! What do you take your sister for?
Never mind. This is your space, and I shouldn't intrude. I've got business to take care of. Bye for now.
Hey! Wait a sec. Those intruders. I wanted to ask. What crime have they committed?
They're plotting to overthrow the architects and bring harm to the city.
Huh. Reminds me of the accusations against me. Kokolia's methods haven't changed.
Don't say that, Serval. I know that you're still nursing a grievance against the Supreme Guardian, but this isn't a joking matter.
You're telling me off again? Fine. Whatever, bro. You better be going. Come listen to Payla in my next rehearsal.
I will, if I have the time.
The coast is clear. You can come out now. Lost my cool when he went for his flask.
This is bad. Rung is in danger. We have to go save her.
Attempting to storm Klopoth Fort by ourselves? Forget it, Zila. I don't care how skilled you are, I'm not sending you on a suicide mission. Rest assured, Kokolia may have changed over the years, but she never hurt Bronya. I'm certain of that.
You sound like Bronya herself. I don't get it. You guys are against Kokolia, and yet in some ways, you seem to trust her completely.
was gauging his reactions just now. Did you see? Unless we have irrefutable evidence, he won't question Kokolia's orders. If you go after him now, our plan's as good as over. Come on, let's go to the restricted zone. If we can get ahead of the curve and find the Stellaron, Kokolia will be out of options.
Is Bronya really safe?
You care about her, huh? You must have become close friends.
Close is a bit much, but I made her a promise.
Relax. She's the strongest girl I've ever seen.
I can believe that.
Oh, they've jacked up security, all right. How the heck are we gonna sneak in? Serval, we need one of those brainwaves.
Leave it to me. Stick close, guys, and don't get spotted.
This is a military base. Trespassers aren't allowed in. Wait, isn't that... Serval! Long time no see.
Well, if it isn't Franz. Long time no see. You still watching the entrance?
Well, you see, you haven't changed, Serval. Still nailing us to the wall. So, what brings you over here at this hour? And who are the guys behind you?
My brother said the restricted zone energy lines were malfunctioning. Told me it was urgent. He doesn't trust those contracted maintenance workers, so he got me in for free. These guys are my assistants. We need to overhaul all the installations here.
I didn't hear anything about the energy lines malfunctioning.
Oh, please. This is a technology division issue. Why would they tell you guys? Come on, let us in already. If the heating system goes down in the middle of the night, are you going to be responsible for all the frozen corpses?
No, that's not something I could handle. Seeing as you're Captain Japard's sister, it should be fine. Okay, here are some temporary passes. Oh, and remember to give them back to me when you leave.
Thanks, Franz. I'll put in a good word for you with my brother and get him to promote you.
No. Captain Japard hates all that under-the-table stuff. I'd have a better chance if you don't mention me at all.
See? That was easy.
You're Japard's sister, all right.
Do you see that mechanical gear bridge? When you cross over to the other side, you arrive at Hell on Earth. They do. The architects believe that Hell can exist on any world, a plight that will inevitably come to be without intervention. In the future, a terrible catastrophe will arrive. If, under Klapoth the Preservation's guidance, we fail to construct a barrier, that catastrophe will sweep away the stars, plunging all worlds into hell. That's the belief of the architects. But for us, hell is an endless fragmentum, a few exhausted Silvermane guards, and the stench of death in the air. If we want to progress further north, we will need to cross that hell. Are you ready?
Exactly. We've got nowhere left to retreat.
Let's go then. First, we need to think of a way to get to the other side. I helped set the underlying mechanisms for this type of gear bridge. It's controlled via different terminals in combination. Let's go find them.
Is Japard on frontline duty a lot?
Yes, but what made you ask that all of a sudden?
It's so dangerous. Don't you worry about him?
He's a Landau.